Welcome to One Chemistry. Always try to do your best. Now let us see about aline. Alines are having axial chirality. We are going to see how we can find R and S configuration. Stay tuned. What is inside this video? Inside this video, we will see what is axial chirality. Then we are going to see how alines are really chiral, how they really are. Then we will see how we can find R and S configuration. Later we will see best examples of it. We will discuss the chiral alline as well as achiral allenes. Now before getting into that, you have to know what is really chiral. Chiral means a three-dimensional difference. We can understand it by shoe there. Shoe are really mirror image of each other, but they are three-dimensionally different. The left shoe never fit for right leg, the right leg never fit for left shoe, vice versa. So left shoe definitely not equal to right shoe, they are different in the space. So they are called chirality. The similar concept we are going to apply in our compound, which is alline. Here the chemicals also can have four kind of chirality. We will discuss only one dimensional one. But the zero dimensional everybody knows, it's a chiral center. The carbon attached with four different atoms. Then one dimensional chirality, which is chiral axis. That's what our today's interest alline. Then two-dimensional chirality, which is chiral plane, which don't have any mirror image, the chirality created by plane. Then three-dimensional chirality, which is created by spiraling. Today we are going to see only alline, and then we'll discuss how we can find R and S configuration. First let us know the alline. Alline is a kind of tricky compound. It attaches with continuous sp2 carbon. Here I given representative alline, chlorine attached alline mod. How they really look you should know. Actually they are two perpendicular plane to each other. One is red plane and blue plane. Exactly they are perpendicular to each other. So if you draw three dimensionally, you ought to know one chlorine above the plane, one hydrogen below the plane, and hydrogen and chlorine on the plane. So three dimensionally you should know how to draw, as well as you have to imagine in the three dimensional way also. How the alines are chiral? Alines are chiral due to the chiral axis. Let us get into the simple fact. Here alline has different attached atom, chlorine and hydrogen. If you draw really, it will be like stretched tetrahedron. If you imagine, it is like chiral carbon, it's a stretched tetrahedron. If you write it simply, it's a simple tetrahedron. Here chirality not created by atom, but chirality created by chiral axis. This is called axial chirality. Here you should know the fact that without chiral carbon, it is chiral. And the chirality created by chiral axis, it makes it optically active too. Before we get into the analysis, you should know whether it is chiral or not. So careful with that, first check the chirality. If it is chiral won't mean we can find R and S. If it is not chiral, we cannot say R and S because it is meaningless too. Here the first compound, it is not chiral because all hydrogens are same. It has mirror plane inside. If you look at the second compound, again it has mirror plane which passes through chlorine. It reflects the hydrogen, it is not chiral. If you look at the third one, it is also not chiral. The compound has odd number of double bond. Then the real interested one, actually the both atoms should be different as well as they are perpendicular to each other. Then only we can say R and S. The bottom one I given, it's a kind of partial spiral. It is also chiral. Then the alline with four different attached atoms, it is also chiral. It is having chiral axis. So you have to know which is chiral, which is not chiral. Before finding R and S, you should know that. Then we will see little bit extra about chirality. The even number of double bonds are chiral. Odd number of double bonds in alines are not chiral. Alines are basically defined as cumulative double bond. Everybody knows simple alline with one double bond, which is alkene there, which is definitely planar because of sp2 carbon, so it is not chiral. If you look at the two double bonded system, which is our present system, it is chiral, we can say R and S, it is non-planar. If you look at the three double bond, what really happens is, the compound become planar, again it's not chiral. If you make it with four double bond, it is also even, so it is chiral, so we can say R and S. But this one is imaginary molecule, impossible to prepare it. We just look into our theoretical interest. We just try to prove our theory. So you have to know odd number of double bonds are not chiral, even number of bonds are chiral. Before we analyze R and S configuration, you have to know viewing side. It is a deciding factor. Here I choose a chlorine side as a viewing side. Here I given the lens for it. Here viewing side is important. Chlorine is below the plane, hydrogen is above the plane. So if you stand there, chlorine will be right side for you, hydrogen will be left side for you, and bromine will be above your head, CH3 will be below your head. But you have to know how to represent in 3 dimension. Here top bottom I given, left right I given. The left right is your seeing side, I written as thick line, which is the viewing side. Back side is thin line, which is the back side. Here given with the atom, so cross verify yourself. It's a very important thing. Before we analyze R and S, you should decide with viewing side. You can choose any way, but you have to consistent with that. Now let us see how we can find R and S. First we have to draw the aniline atom, and we have to find the viewing angle, which is viewing side there. Then we have to decide the viewing side. Then front side get higher priority than back side, then apply the CIP rule. It's a very important one. Front side gets higher priority than back side. Here AB is front side, CD is back side. Then you have to draw with a 2-dimensional representation, ABCD. Then front side get higher priority. Front side is A and B, which is chlorine and hydrogen. Chlorine get first priority, then hydrogen. Then the back side, which is hydrogen and chlorine. Chlorine get higher priority, then hydrogen. So if you analyze the configuration, it is anti-clockwise direction. The new name you can say it as M. So clockwise mean R, new name is P. Anti-clockwise mean S, new name is M. Here the important thing you should know is front hydrogen get higher priority even than the back side chlorine. So the important is priority, not the atomic number. So that's how you have to find the configuration. Then you have to avoid your confusion. That's why given the same compound, change the viewing side. Here the first one viewing side is AB. Chlorine will be right side, COH will be left side. COH above, chlorine below, CND. The configuration will be 1, 2, 3, 4, which is anti-clockwise, which is yes. Suppose one person choosing opposite side. Again, you have to choose COH is above the plane, CL is below the plane. The priority is front side 1. You have to give the priority number there. Then the back side, chlorine will come left side for you. So if you do again also, it will also 1, 2, 3, 4, anti-clockwise, yes direction. So viewing side doesn't matter. You have to choose by your own interest. Then the change of chlorine atom, here the change of substituent. What will happen? Change in configuration. In the left side, chlorine is below, right side, chlorine is above. So let us analyze the configuration. The viewing side is same. You are viewing it and ABCD. The A will be right side, which is chlorine, B is hydrogen. Then you have to write the priority of front side. Chlorine get first, hydrogen get second. Same with back side, it will get anti-clockwise. Once you change the chlorine atom, priority changes, you have clockwise direction. So change the atom, change the configuration. Careful with that, don't forget that. Here aline also have same property like any other chiral carbon. Mirror image having opposite configuration. Here I given the aline which has mirror image of each other. Let us analyze the configuration. The viewing sides are same. In the left side you are seeing from chlorine hydrogen. In the right side compound you are seeing from bromine and methyl. So if you find the front side and back side atom, then analyze the configuration. Left side will be clockwise, right side will be anti-clockwise. Here what changes the fact here? Because in the left side HCl is front side, right side Br and CH3 is front side. So mirror images always cancel each other, which is opposite configuration. Then I given some example to practice yourself. So practice yourself how can find R and S configuration. I want to mention a few. The second compound, which is a kind of spirane, but again you have to look at the terminal carbon for the chirality. Here the terminal carbon create the chirality, same our method, front side and back side, you have to choose it. And the third one, again a benzene, double bond get higher priority than single bond, again the same CIP rule, same front side and back side. Then the fourth one with deuterium, the deuterium will have higher atomic number than hydrogen, so it will get higher priority. So you have to practice yourself as much as possible to get the concept better. So let us summarize the important points. Always check the chirality before finding R and S. You have to choose the chiral axis and viewing angle. If it is clockwise direction, you have to choose R or new name P. If it is anti-clockwise orientation, yes, new name M. Then I given the prominent example of chiral and not chiral. If all are hydrogen, definitely it is not chiral. If the carbon have same atoms there, it will also not chiral. It will create plane of symmetry. Then odd number of double bonds are not chiral. Finally, the spirene kind of compounds also can be represented with this kind of R and S configuration. That's all for this video. I hope it was useful. Thanks for watching. If you find my videos useful, subscribe and share it.